Did you know that Melody Patterson actually lied about her age to be cast in the popular F Troop sitcom? Even though she claimed to be 18, she was actually a minor, which was strictly not allowed by the show. But how did this affect her career when showrunners finally discovered the truth? Stay tuned to find out. Melody Patterson started her career when she was just 4 years old. Born in 1949 in California, Patterson was considered the star of her family. Ever since she could remember, she loved performing in front of people. Many believed she had got this trait from her mother after she had been a dancer with Warner Brothers in the past. Seeing her passion for dancing and singing, Patterson's family thought it would be a great idea to connect her with a couple of small-time projects. Not too long passed until Patterson started appearing in theater plays. She acted in her first play called Mrs. McThing at the Downey Community Theater in Downey, California when she was just 4 years old. And in the following year, Patterson even managed to write and direct her own play. By the age of 10, she had become a skillful actress, model, and ice skater. Despite her young age, Patterson was nowhere near stopping. In fact, her aim was to be a global success. After finishing the ninth grade, her parents enrolled her in the Hollywood Professional School. Since then, her main focus was to be educated on perfecting her acting skills and performance. Patterson later completed her studies after attending the American Academy of Dramatic Arts in New York City. She lied about her age to get cast in the F Troop sitcom. But throughout this whole period, she was also making a name for herself in the filming industry. She was acting in the famous sitcom called F Troop. Her role in F Troop, which made its debut in 1965 and ran for 2 seasons on ABC, was her first as a professional actress. Patterson was the last of numerous actresses to audition for the part, but miraculously got accepted anyway. However, there was one big problem during her audition. She actually lied about her age to get accepted. At the time of her audition, Patterson had just turned 16, but told producers she would be 18 really soon and would therefore be out of school. But the main reason why she was accepted wasn't really about her lie. It was actually because Patterson had good chemistry with a person that was set up to be her love interest in the show, who was played by Ken Berry. She even talked about this herself in an interview in 2011, saying that she had an instant connection with the actor, and it was just like magical chemistry between two people. Fortunately, Patterson managed to film 7 episodes of the show before being discovered. By then, she was an integral part of the show about a bumbling army troop stationed at a remote outpost. So it wasn't really in the show's interest to dismiss her and find another actress. But although she was discovered, the veteran actors and showrunners treated her no differently. Patterson even revealed that they treated her kindly and with full respect. A radio show attempted to humiliate her in front of the whole nation. Many years later, Patterson recalled that her agent warned her that Howard Stern might try to embarrass her during an interview on his radio show, but the actress didn't even flinch. She just told her agent that she was courageous enough to do it, and she didn't fear any interviewer. Patterson prepared for the interview and aced it, leaving no room for Stern to push her in the corner. When F Troop finally came to an end, Patterson continued to appear in other series, such as The Monkees and Green Acres. She also gave films a shot as well, but she only managed to be cast in low-budget ones, including The Cycle Savages and Blood and Lace, both released in the early 70s. But even though she appeared in countless projects throughout her life, she still considered F Troop to be the biggest thrill and success of her career. Patterson's first marriage was a roller coaster of love and disaster. Melody Patterson married a total of 3 times. Her first husband was actor James MacArthur. MacArthur was known for the role of Dan Dano Williams in the TV series Hawaii Five-0. However, Patterson wasn't his first wife. He was previously married to Joyce Boulafont. When he met with Patterson, he was still smarting from the rupture of his first marriage and had even sworn to never marry again. He described his first marriage similar to be living in a dream come true. When talking about it in an interview, he said that his marriage was perfect. He had a nice house, a loving partner, and 2 kids. But in just a blink of an eye, everything shattered. He said that out of nowhere, he was filing for divorce from his first wife, and he wasn't even clear as to why. James was then cast adrift in a sea of social gatherings. As a star of the hit TV series Hawaii Five-0, he was one of the most wanted men in Honolulu, where the program is filmed, or anywhere else for that matter. He kind of enjoyed his newfound freedom. After a while, the memory of married life began to get dimmer and dimmer. Then he met Melody Patterson at a party. When he first met Patterson, she was a peaches and cream blonde with obvious good looks, a wonderfully optimistic attitude, and a bubbly personality. James got interested. An expert skier, he invited Melody on a ski trip. From one point of view, this date didn't turn out too well. Melody fell and broke her leg. Yet the accident, which kept them off the slopes, enabled them to get to know one another. Other ski trips followed, and Melody visited James in Hawaii. But even so, most observers were skeptical when a friend of James planted the idea of him getting married to her in his head. At first, James denied it and shook it off with a laugh. Then, a few months ago, Melody and James went through a horrible breakup. She told her loyal manager that the break was traumatic for her, but that regardless of the sorrow of parting, she was still glad she'd known James MacArthur, as she really fell in love with the actor. Surprisingly, this separation only made the pair fall in love even more with each other. And, obviously, they got back together. While James was in Hawaii, at work on Hawaii Five-0, he discovered he loved Melody so much he wanted to marry her. So, to show her how he felt, he bought a $12,000 engagement ring set with a 5-carat heart-shaped diamond and asked Melody to accept it. She not only accepted the ring, but Jim's proposal of marriage and pledge of eternal love. The couple then got married in a cave in 1970. But this marriage would continue being even more rocky and dramatic throughout the years. Just 7 years after their marriage, both of them ended up filing for divorce. Patterson eventually married a second time with Robert Hill Crump Seton Jr. This marriage was also a failure, and both of them ended up separating in 1998. The only person she ended up settling with until the end was musician Vern Miller. But despite being married 3 times, she never had any children. Unfortunately, Patterson started having health complications when she entered her 60s, and in 2015, she passed away at a nursing home in Hollister, Missouri, at the age of 66. What shocked you the most about this actress's life? Let us know in the comments, and don't forget to check out the next video in this series.